Hello, my name is Curt Wehrley. I am the Quantitative Analyst and a Currency Coach at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, December 15th, 2011. This is a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York morning session. First, let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. We do not provide an alert service, and the currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a one-hour chart for the Euro-USD currency pair as that chart looked at 9 a.m. New York time today on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. I've got this chart zoomed out to show price action since roughly the middle part of Tuesday's Asian session. You can see in the lower right-hand portion of this chart how the Euro has basically been flip-flopping like a fish out of the water today, making for some challenging trading during today's London session. Today's London session low right there, being higher than yesterday's low right there, might be an early clue that the recent downtrend was started in late October is coming to an end. But until we start seeing a persistent pattern of more green than red, it's reasonable to assume that traders will continue to seek to sell this currency pair. One basic trading principle is to sell on rallies to resistance. While the latest green hourly candle was forming, the one on the right-hand part of this chart there, I discussed during that candle in the live class multiple prospective sources of resistance in the 1.30 50 to 1.3060 zone. Near 1.3050, a so-called midpoint psychological level, you've got the daily R1 pivot point, represented by a horizontal maroon colored line on the right-hand portion of this chart. The downward sloping blue line represents the hourly 55 EMA. That's a prospective source of dynamic resistance. And at 1.3060, you've got the horizontal bright red line representing Tuesday's New York morning low on the left-hand portion of this chart and yesterday's high, both of those identified by red arrows. And if I draw a Fibonacci study of the move down from Tuesday's high here to yesterday's low right there, I learned that the 38.2% Fibonacci retracement level of that move down is represented here by another bright red horizontal line sitting just below 1.3060. The first opportunity to enter a short just below 1.3050 came together less than 20 minutes before 9 a.m. New York time. And you can see the top of the hourly candle, just barely make out the top of the hourly candle there. Traders looking for a second chance short got that just a few minutes before the opening bell on the New York Stock Exchange. Let me show you that on a 3-minute chart. Here's a 3-minute chart as it looked at 9:30 a.m. New York time. First chance short at the daily R1 near 1.3050 right there. And notice on the far right, upper right hand portion of the chart how the euro stalled for a few minutes at about 1.3045, just minutes before the U.S. equity market opened, providing a second chance short trade entry there. Okay, so let's go back to the hourly chart. Over the next 150 minutes, the euro fell about 70 pips to match its Asian session lows. Let's highlight those with a blue line. There's the Asian session lows. Euro fell about 70 pips to match those lows, then finished the European trading day just above the 1.30 handle. Depending on your exit strategy, there are between 20 to 60 pips of profit to be had from that move down that I'm highlighting now in blue. By the way, while the euro was hovering just below the 1.3050 level during the minutes before the U.S. equity market opened, the Aussie was also hovering in a familiar area. Let's take a look at that chart. During yesterday's New York session video review, I discussed a short trade entry on this currency pair near the 99.80 level. Tuesday's low for this pair was very close to the horizontal blue line near the top of this chart, and you can see the Aussie spent nearly an hour testing that 99.80 area. Like the Euro move I just showed you a moment ago, the Aussie fell soon after the U.S. equity market opened, fell about 70 pips from its high for the day. Again, my name is Curt Wehrley, and this has been your New York session video review from FX Bootcamp.com for Thursday, December 15th.